version is the pop version. Think about this very seriously. The second version, and we started this class with Robert Johnson, the second version really is the pop version of the Son House song, Walkin' Blues, and that's the jump from 1930 to 1936. It's also, think about it, available as pop music because it's shortened, isn't it, to fit on a 78 RPM record. It's crisper. The interplay of musicians and so forth and so on is being done by one person. And when we started this class talking about Robert Johnson, we did so for a reason. Robert Johnson is playing with the cultural place that the Son House Walkin' Blues song used to occupy, and he's moved it into an entirely different cultural zone. And also, thinking about it, it is pop music relative to the Son House version. It just is. How can you get around that? I don't see any way around it. Do you? As we run over today, and thank you for letting me. So when we talk about Robert Johnson, we have to be very cautious. When we talk about any music, we have to be very cautious. We have to understand folk music from many different perspectives. And what Robert Johnson did was clean up the mess. What Robert Johnson did was clean up the mess that becomes authenticity for decades and decades and decades. He saw that his broom kept the musical genre clean. He swept it, and it codified, and it was to anyone, and should still be, I think, to anyone, authenticity on many, 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 many levels. With this in mind, with this framework in mind, Robert Johnson's move into pop music as a result of Son House. We're still in the area of folk music and folk process, but within that area, let us never, ever, ever be conservative. Thank you.